We did study the vowels, the consonants, and the combination of these two types, which become as the consonantal vowels. There are 12 vowels and 18 consonants, and in combination we get consonantal vowels. That is to say, it is ik, a consonant, plus a, a vowel. The result is ka, a consonantal vowel. Ik plus a became ka. This is elongated. A is an elongation of a. So naturally, the consonantal vowel gets an elongated sound. Ka. With this combination also, we saw a few words. For instance, call. Call is a leg. This is kal. Ka and il. This is ka and il. This means a leg and this means a stone. So the elongation of the consonantal vowel brings in a difference in the meaning. Kal and kal. What is this? Non and non. Non is the capital I. Non. And here we did discuss a grammatical point. That is to say, this na will rarely come as the last letter of any Tamil word, and this na can never be the first letter of any Tamil word. Another vowel, the third vowel, I. So what will be the combination? Combination is ki. How do we write it? This is ka, as you know, and you put a kar at the end of the right side. From the right end, you elongate the line, make a kar, bring it down and end it equally along the letter. So this is ki. So naturally, the next letter we take up is na and e. This is ni. The one thing which we have to remember in writing these letters is where to start the marker. We can call it a marker. A mark which makes the letter to sound differently. If there is no marker, it is ka. With this marker, it is ki. And as we saw earlier, this is a marker, and when it is added to a consonantal vowel, the whole becomes one elongated letter ka. Now, like that, we have a marker to denote the vowel e. So, ik plus e, ki. Next letter, ng plus e, ni. This is ki. As you have in the English words, kill, kit, and kin. It, ta, with a dot above, and you add a vowel e and it becomes t. Now you don't have any right end ending. Where do you start? So you have to put it in the middle. So the way it is written is ta in the middle you take this bend, extend it, and this becomes T, as you have in tin, tip and tick. N plus E, knee. Ka, na, cha, nya, ta, na. Then the next letter is ta. With a dot above, it becomes it. And you add this vowel, it becomes T. Now we have the next letter ni. This is a combination of N or N plus E, ni. Ni. After na you have pa, if plus E, this becomes P. See, I take the curve from the right end. If plus E, P. Plus E is me. Here you have to notice, as you don't have any right edge, you have to start on the very letter, in the middle of the letter, that is ma, and in the middle of the letter you take this marker and extend it. This is me, ya, with a dot above the consonant. R with a consonant. You put a vowel and it becomes E. Please note, I start from the right end. E plus E, E. This E is a back vowel and E happens to be a middle one, and with R you have re, R plus E, re. Please note, in R you have that this extension at the end, and when you add a vowel you need not have this extension, because without this extension it is not going to be different in pronunciation. The next letter is L plus E, li. This is la, and you have this marker here. This is L plus E, li. Lip, limb and lit. The next letter is, as you know, U, that is wa with a dot above, and in combination it becomes wa and V. U plus E, V. Now I would like to suggest again this re, li, re, and ni are at the end of the consonants.